Selinexor, to my mind, is an important oral option that's valuable in the setting of particularly deletion 17p positive relapsed refractory myeloma, where I personally have seen, felt its use is incredibly helpful in selected patients. One of the challenges with Selinexor is dose and schedule, and what we've learned is that if you combine it with other drugs and use it weekly and start low, go slow, go from say 40 to 60 to 80 milligrams a week with an aggressive approach to antiemetics and in combination, it performs very well. So I think our feeling around Selinexor is there's plenty of data to support its use, first with the STORM trial and then more recently with Boston and the ongoing data being derived from STOMP. But I think the biggest takeaway is we've learned how to use it better. And in certainly in patients with high-risk disease, my own clinical experience with it has been encouraging.